The Petrie family has lived in Steilacoom for more than 11 years, but today they make it official. This reception, half a world away from the battlefield, is for Sergeant First Class Leroy Petrie. He's lived his childhood dream to join the Army, a dream that became a career with the 75th Rangers.
8 deployments, 6 to Afghanistan, 2 to Iraq.
A dream that came with pain in battle.
My legs are still killing me. In fact, feels like they're getting worse. But
they talk about my hand, which it's the most noticeable. And the big thing is my legs. A lot of people don't know I've been shot through my legs, and those hurt more than my arm does.
On a mission to capture Taliban, Petrie was shot through both legs. Then a grenade landed next to him and 2 others. He grabbed it to throw it back when it exploded in his hand. Sergeant Petrie continued to give orders and to lead his squad.
With that selfless act, Leroy saved his 2 Ranger brothers, and they are with us today. This valor came with a price. The force of the blast took Leroy's right hand. Shrapnel riddled his body.
And for his bravery, Petrie became only the 2nd living veteran since the Vietnam War to receive the Medal of Honor.
A lot of people will say this is a heavy medal to wear around your neck, and it makes it lighter for me the more people I share it with. After all, I tell people it does belong to every man and woman who has and is serving in our military.
To honor his service and his sacrifice, the Military Warriors Support Foundation gathered generous donations from anonymous donors, companies, and banks to buy the Petries their first house.
Providing homes for soldiers is the largest part of what we do. We've donated over $130 million worth of homes the past 3 years to warriors in 42 states.
The Petries get the deed to their house. There is no mortgage. It's all part of the goal of the foundation to help soldiers transition into civilian life.
Your heart is just racing because it's filled with so much emotion, knowing that I have a place for the family.
It's a home, a shelter, a place to raise their 4 children.
As I do continue to support our military men and women, combat injured and wounded and ill, that if it takes me on the road, that I know my family will be here in a wonderful house with a great town. Gosh. And safe.
And for the first time, there are neighbors to meet.
If there's anything we can do for you all, please feel free.
Yeah, we were telling your husband, we're like family here. Eggs, lawnmowers, blowers, tools.
Getting the keys means they really are home.
Come on in.
With views of Puget Sound, ferries, and sunsets, this house is filled with luxuries the Petries never imagined.
Bathrooms that we don't have to share.
Daughter Reagan, a 10th grader, gets a bedroom closet every teen dreams of.
I was just so overwhelmed because I've never seen this. I haven't been in here before.
Landon, a 4th grader, still wanted a room close to mom and dad.
I'm really excited for them because they've been kind of waiting for a while to find a good house and a house that we can actually call home, because lately we've been renting houses.
A little place to sit and have coffee. Yeah. A lot of people spend their entire lives paying for a home. And to have the gift of a home, to have it in our town that we love, is just it's a blessing for our family.
A new home and a new future. Leroy is headed back to school to pursue a degree in business and accounting, a dream his injuries will not put on hold.
The hardest part was learning to write again, and my son was 5 at the time, so he was getting ready for kindergarten, so we spent the summer together learning our ABCs.
And Leroy Petrie will continue to help his fellow wounded soldiers.
I can't go back to kicking down doors and shooting bad guys, and I want to do the next best thing, and that's helping those returning service members that are in that situation, like I was.
The Petrie family is home.
Happy birthday to you.
Bob Fronson, Pierce County TV.